Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. If I drop anything, it will fall down. And we all know the reason, gravity. Anything around the earth, if left free, will fall towards the center of earth. Then, why the moon is not falling and hitting the earth? Similarly, why orbiting satellites are not falling down to earth? Let's understand the real physics behind it, and I will not use the word centrifugal force in this explanation. Let's go to the top of a hill and throw balls in horizontal direction using this cannon. First, let's throw with a small velocity, and this is how it would go. And all of us know it. It falls down and covers a small horizontal distance. And now, let's throw it with a slightly higher speed in the same direction. It again falls to earth, but covers a larger distance. Let's increase the speed bit more, and it goes like this. Remember, the gravity is always directed towards the center of earth. So, the ball is continuously pushed towards the center of earth by gravity. Let's increase the speed further, and now it almost reaches one half of the earth. On further increase of speed, it almost completes one full circle and falls on this part of earth. And what if we increase the speed further? The gravity continuously pushes it towards the center of earth, and the ball continues falling towards the center of earth, but it continuously misses the surface of earth and remains in the space forever. And we say that the ball is now in a circular orbit and has become a satellite of earth. This is how moon and satellites revolve around earth. And this is how earth revolves around sun. For example, if I throw a ball from sea level with a speed of 7.9 km per second in horizontal direction, the ball will start orbiting the earth if we neglect air resistance. Why does this happen? Because earth is spherical, if we move in horizontal direction, we can afford to fall a certain height and still remain at the same height from the surface of earth at the new position. And when we fall by that exact height, and when we remain at the same height from the surface of earth, we are on orbit. The mass and shape of the object do not matter. And with what speed should we throw? At sea level, it is 7.9 km per second. What if we throw at a higher speed than this? The object starts orbiting earth like this in an elliptical path, and such an orbit is called elliptical orbit. What if we throw with a much higher speed? The rate of falling becomes much lesser and it leaves the earth forever. That speed of throw, beyond which it leaves earth, is termed as escape velocity, and it is 11.2 km per second at sea level. So, if you are strong enough to throw something with a speed higher than 11.2 km per second from sea level, you can send that object out of earth to the deep space. And another thing, as we go higher and higher, the speed with which we should throw an object to put it into an orbit or orbital velocity reduces. Why? This is because as we go farther and farther from the center of Earth or higher and higher in the atmosphere, the pull or effect of gravity reduces and the height by which an object falls for the same time reduces. For example, at 150 km altitude, if a body falls by 467 meter during 10 seconds, at an altitude of 10,000 km, the same body would fall by only 74 meter for the same time. That means we need to give more time at higher altitudes to fall to maintain the same altitude, or we need to throw slower. Thus, the orbital velocity reduces with altitude. At 150 km, it is 7.8 km per second, and at 10,000 km, you need to throw by only 4.9 km per second. And have you ever wondered what a rocket does while launching a satellite? It just goes to the required altitude, attain the right speed, and throw the satellite in the required direction. For example, if a rocket is intended to launch a satellite into circular orbit of 150 km altitude, the final stage of rocket reaches 150 km altitude, attains almost a velocity of 7.8 km per second, and just mildly push the satellite into the orbit with a velocity of 7.8 km per second. So next time, when you hear about a rocket launching a satellite, Do note these parameters and have complete understanding of those. That's it for today. Subscribe and be with us. Signing off, Science for Common Man.